Hey everybody, so we just tried to do another live stream and we're having bandwidth issues apparently. It cut out on us, so we thought, okay, we want to get this tutorial out, so we're gonna...
Third time's a charm.
Yeah, so we're just gonna record this, upload it. Sorry, it's not live.
Yep.
But if we were live streaming,
this would
be our setup. We would be streaming to YouTube. We're gonna try going down from 6 megabytes per second down to 4.5 and see if we get better results with that.
We have our PTZ Optics 20X USB camera, the Audio Technica AT3031 connected to the Behringer UMC 202 HD, the Papalook 720p camera. We're usually using vMix Social on Kindle Fire.
If we were live, we'd be trying that again.
We have a laptop with vMix desktop capture sending NDI, and of course our vMix mousepad Freedom Edition, our X-keys 124 T-bar with the video switcher key set, and we're running vMix Pro on an MSI laptop.
Yes, we are. and what we want to talk about today, and I'm going to talk about, is backlighting. And what we have here is, if you were to tear your X-keys 80 apart, which I don't recommend because it voids the warranty, this is kind of what you would find. We start at the top with our keycap, and then below that we have this thing we call a key plunger that goes into these cylinders and goes down to compress this elastomeric membrane. And there's a carbon button on the bottom of this membrane that when it goes down, it closes contacts here, and that's what makes our switch closure. And the way that, let's see, I have to reset here for a second. If you were to get an X-keys off the shelf without making any modifications to it and plug it in, it would come on with both the red and the blue backlights on at 50% intensity. If you look over here in our backlighting utility, which we have a link in the comments to that, and there's the URL for it that Rand just put up. This is the intensity on each bank, and bank one is blue, bank two is red. And you can have fun playing around with these in the utility. You can turn both banks off. We can turn individual LEDs on so you can see what they look like. And this was, you know, backlighting for X-keys, it was really designed to be a general glow, kind of an overall color in areas of the X-keys. But in vMix, we can use it for key indication. And there are some things that we can do to help optimize it for that. We're going to show you that now. What we recommend for if you're going to use it in vMix is to set both of these banks at full intensity. That's 255. And you can see how bright that is. And then we recommend that you turn both of them off and hit save to set that as the default backlighting. So that way when vMix recognizes your X-keys, there are no backlights on, and it can manipulate the backlights with its activators by turning them on and showing your keys.
Right.
The other issue we have, since this was designed for a general overall glow, is that we get bleed over from key to key. And so we have designed this clever little, what we call backlight mask. It's just a piece of cardstock that's black that fits over all the keys and kind of masks the bleed over so that you get better individual key indication as those lights come on. And that's something that's available from our website, or you just contact us and we'd be happy to get one of those to you.
Yep.
So there's backlighting, and that's how to optimize an X-keys for vMix.
Right.
Anything else?
I think that's all. Well, we're gonna try again for the show next week.
I'm on vacation, but Miranda's taking over next week.
Yep.
I know she's going to do a great job. So come on in on Friday next week and watch Miranda and give her some comments, to give her some questions to answer.
Yep.
And we might have somebody else in here with you. We'll see.
Might have a special guest.
We'll leave that as a surprise. Okay.
All right.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. We're going to keep trying until we get this down.
Bye.
Bye.